Sam Gagno, Audrey Langlois, and Cassidy Turk are about to be recognized as seniors. It's senior night in Chazy at Chazy Central Rural School. It's the first day of February 2024. And we're here for varsity girls basketball in the MVAC. It's the Seton Catholic Lady Knights visiting the Eagles. Eagle coach Josh Howell has the microphone. And he's not going to sing the anthem. He's going to start introducing the senior night activities here as soon as he feels the crowd has settled down. I'll give you the visitors lineup while we're waiting. Coached by Keegan Briggs, assisted by Ariel Maston. Daylon Willette, 3. Emma Langlois, 5. Bianca Spiegel, 10. Monique Allen, 11. Grace Trombley, 12. Megan Mast is 15. Gabriella Conti is 20. Grace Mezzacapa is 21. Christina Conti, 22. Lydia Waba is 23. And Chloe Lawless is number 30. For the Chazy side, Steph Barrier, 1. Emma Howell, 2. Audrey Langlois, 3. Winter Jarris, 4. Callie Schwartz is 15, maybe. Yep, 15.
Okay, we're
gonna, there we go. We'll get back to this. Listen to Josh.
Second, I'd like to thank all of our parents. Obviously, as varsity basketball players, most can drive now, but we've spent years and years and years traveling girls back and forth to practice, so we appreciate that. Kristen Turk, I'd like to say thank you for all your help getting the gifts ready for the girls, so thank you. So with that, I will go ahead and get started. Before I get to our seniors, I would like to recognize Seton's two seniors as well. Gabriella Conti. And Emma Williams.
Conti and Langlois. Family.
Thank you.
were taken with a fellow senior.
Our next senior is Audrey Langlois.
Langlois.
And Audrey is the daughter of Jason and Jenny Langlois and sister Kate.
Seems like some of these parents just graduated a few years back and they're already with their senior athletes.
And our third senior tonight is Samantha Gagliardo.
It's two senior boys. So, I again thank you. Tonight, Coach Josh Howell. I think we got as far as Callie Schwartz, 15. Kaylin Dunbar, 11. Cassidy Turk, 13. Sam Gagno, 14. Kennedy Columbus, 22. And Carly Lapierre is 25. They'll be introducing the lineups momentarily for you about 15 minutes from now for us, because they haven't started their warm-ups yet. Tonight, there'll be three of them. Brian Marino, Barry Rock, and Steve Brown. When we get to this time of the year, they like to get used to the three-man formation because that's what they use in the sectionals, and we're only a couple weeks away from the sectionals. And they show up with three officials, and they split two payments between the three, so schools aren't charged with paying for three officials. So only when you get to the sectionals. And speaking of the sectionals, Chazy with a big win over previously unbeaten Bolton is hoping to make it to the championship game, and one of the teams they're going to have to maybe face along that route would be the Seton Catholic Lady Knights. So it's a big game for both teams. Won't fall, and controlled by a turret, and she gets it to Langlois. Temperature 37 degrees, and we set our vehicle off the day before Groundhog Day, so we're hoping for cloudy skies all day tomorrow. That means the winter will be over. I can only find the groundhog. That is in and out. That was, I believe, Allen. Now here's Langlois. Pierre throws it up. It's a rebound. Puts it in. Larry Pierre. He was a big factor in that victory against Bolton. Ball on the shot clock. The rim. The Knights having trouble to get him to foul. And we're going to have a foul. I believe it's Spiegel. Something with a zero on it. Maybe it's Lawless. Let's see. 20. Nope. Neither one. It's Conti. Foul was on Conti, number 20. Turret. Eagles lead 4-0. What? Oh no, we got an injury here. An eye injury on Turret. So she'll be okay. We had, we got 11. Dunbar in. And Kaylin Dunbar makes her presence known with a three-pointer and a 7-0 Chazy lead. We're at 4:42 here in the third. Howell goes down hard. That ball. Blue time. Seton Catholic ball. Like a wrestling official. Dunbar coming over to hold it. Knights will give a full court press into Langlois. Numbers are a little tough to pick up there. They're white number, white outline, blue number on a blue shirt. So very difficult to pick up. 3:56, we're halfway through the first period. Off Gagneau. Turk looks like she's ready to come back. Dunbar with the rebound. Langlois will bring it up. Off the rim and a shot by Howell. Langlois tracks it down. Howell out to Langlois. Up here in the paint. Knights come up with the ball. Whoops. Whoops away by Langlois. That's Trombley who's trying to pivot. White time. Turk back in, she'll give Gagneau a rest. I'm sure what the discussion is about. Deep for Langlois. Howell. It in. Emma Howell. Nice move to the hoop. Exit 9-0. Don't tell the scorekeeper, they still score 7-0 up there. Nice looking to get on the board. Rebound Turret. Give it to Langlois. Now the 9 is up on the board. T- Kurt throws it up, way up the mark. Knights with the ball. It's a 30 Lawless in the high post. 9-0, 2-12, first period. Langlois into the forecourt. Bar to Langlois. LaPierre is fouled. Shooting two. This is the first. Has the ball. 12, that's Trombley. Conte up to 5, Langlois. Wallace is out there. Who's the other one? 11, Allen. Knights turn it over. Now we got 15 is in. Charlie Schwartz. And for LaPierre. Eagles turn it over. We're at 121. Block, a foul will be fouled. So they'll send Lawless to the line. Foul will be on Langlois. Lawless will shoot two. This is the first. Tying up Schwartz. 53 seconds. Knights don't want to be shut out here in the first quarter. Off blue. Turk will inbound to Langlois. Pointer. She's got half her team's 12 points since coming off the bench. Rebound Turret. 10 seconds to go. Chazy up 12-0. Now, Langlois. Turret. Matthew Turret taps off a 15 point. First quarter for the Eagles, they're up 15-0. And Chazy will have the ball to start the second quarter. And the Langlois. 14-0. Eagles. Three-pointer is off the back of the iron. Daniel rebound. And off balance, she shuffles a little bit. Blue ball. And a basket count. And a basket count. Grace Trombley puts her team on the scoreboard. Foul is on Lapeer. She'll have a chance for a three-point play. Down up here. Mark Lewis brings it up. Third. Funny, okay. Conte, it's just Gabriella Conte. There are two of them, Christina and Gabriella. This is Gabriella. The numbers are green and the outline is white. And the reason they do that on the Seton Catholic numbers is because, as you can see, the green MAI's colors were blue and gold. St. John's were green and white, so they try to keep the green and the blue on all their uniforms, although it's been since 89 or 90 that those two schools merged to form Seton Catholic. So, Langlois can't get him to fall. Remains 17-2. DeGagno. Allen over to Conte, to Langlois. And getting the shot off to Tom Blade. She has all four of her team's points. Under six to go in a half. And a howl. Another nice move to the basket. Makes it 21-4. Chazy scored 84% of the points. Blocked by Turk. Langlois is fouled by Trombley. They're following a timeout. The Eagles will bring it up. Cross court, underneath to Lapeer. Player down for the Knights. Lawless is helped off the floor by coaches Howell and Briggs. Seton ball. Travel call. I think maybe Spiegel came in for injured player. I think I saw 10 out there. Too hard, it'll be off white. Yep, that's Spiegel. Our grandma. Meg, come in. Another basket by Trombley. 21-6, 4:27 to go in the half. Rania over the turret. Langlois back. Rania underneath for Lapierre. Shot off, that's, what was that, five? That's Langlois. Pierre grabs it, has it knocked out of her hand, knocks it loose. Powell knocks it loose. Whoa, last touch by Blue. And Langlois will bring it up. 3:24. Both teams have scored six here in the second quarter. Rania with a steal. Owl for three. Shows that she can do more than just drive to the basket. She can pop in those three-pointers. That one falls in for Gabriella Conte for the Knights. That's 24-9, 2:25 to go in the second. Trombley is injured. He's in pain. And Barrier's in now. Replacing her cousin Howell. Keep it. 25-9. 2 minutes to go in the first half. Off the glass, off the rim, and rebound by Gagno. Lapierre. That's it in. 27-9, 3-1 margin for the Eagles. Grabbed by Barrier, stolen and put in by Emma Langlois. 27-11, we're down to 1 minute to go in the half. Are working hard to keep that ball away from Lapierre as they got Dunbar in for Gagno. This one. Timeout. Langlois. It's the first. Knights have outscored Chazy 13-12 here in the second quarter. 9 seconds to go. And 27-13 will be the halftime score. Chazy leading the Seton Catholic Knights here on viewer-supported hometown cable. Well, this time the Knights will have the ball to start the quarter. They'll start the second half. Trailing by 14, they made up 1 point there on the Eagles in the second quarter. Eagles with the steal. Cross court to Howell. Here, this is it off to Gagno, the turret. And Gagno is fouled by Lydia Wabach, 23. Also see Christina Conti in the first time we notice Christina in. Gagno throws it up. Rebounded by Gabriella Conta. Or Conti, I should say. Langlois traveled. Points have been scored. Langlois, Howell. Appear on the high post. Get up! 13. Block by Howell, she's gonna call for a foul. At the line. Ball rattled in and out on the first attempt. With a steal, and she is fouled by Christina Conte. Conte, foul on Conte. Looking for a timeout. Kurt, into Langlois. Over to Howell, three. Wow. 32-14. There's the ball. Turk will give it to Langlois. Howell back to Ganyo. Appear in the high post. Emma Howell. Rebounded by Langlois. Audrey Langlois. Each team has a Langlois. Almost stolen away by Allen. Sub coming in. Who we got here? 10. Spiegel back in. Bianca Spiegel. By number 12, Trombley. She's back in and doing good. Manuel tries to bounce pass. Oh, wow, wow. Hitting the floor hard was Trombley. Wow. Dunbar is coming back in for Ganyo. Allen picks it up. Rolls the rim. Up and in by Trombley. He's fired up. 35-18. perimeter. Dunbar tried to go to LaPierre. Should go to LaPierre. Knights have the ball. Real 8 to go in the third. Chazy leading by 17, 35 to 18. Lanyo got it to Dunbar, to Turek. Dunbar for three. Spiegel got the rebound. Again, these dark green numbers on a blue shirt are really tough to pick up. I know in the old days, if both the green and blue weren't on the uniforms, they'd get complaints. And depending on which school was eliminated from the uniform, either MAI or St. John's. Same thing occurs with the NAC with the green and gold. Off her knee, LaPierre back in. He'll come in for Dunbar. 1:56 showing in the third quarter. Dunbar brings it up. For three, no. Rebound Trombley. Spiegel. And we get a foul on Gagneau. +17 showing in the third. Here with the foul. So that's number 5, it looks like. It would be Langlois. Seton Catholic timeout. We'll have the foul shot. Jump ball. Daisy's turn. Clock ticking. Happens often here, Daisy. Howell, that one's a wee bit short. Dunbar in, replaced Howell. At the line. Hit off the guide wires. Goes Chazy ball. Out of bounds, it hits the wires. 33 seconds to go in the third quarter. Knights take it away. Conte. There you go, Conte. Shot by Trombley, 8 seconds. Blue ball. In the corner by Allen. And it's back to a 15-point difference, 35-20 after three on viewer-supported hometown cable. It was 15-0 at the end of the first quarter. Both teams have scored 20 since then. Spiegel will inbound. I think 20. I think it was 20. Her shot was a little bit short. 12-point game. 7:34 to go. Pointer would make it a single-digit deficit. And a two-pointer makes it a 10-point deficit. Langlois makes it a 10-point game. Knights looking for a big comeback here in the fourth quarter. Howell, the back of the iron. I'm not sure that one. Conte called for carrying it, but I think she did a good job of avoiding that high bounce. But again, eye of the beholder. Turret, that's the drive. Dunbar, no. Put back in by Turret. Important basket for Chazy. It's been a while since they'd scored. 37-25, back to a 12-point Eagle lead. 6:19 to go in the game, and we got travel called. Travel. Langlois was looking to get it to Turk, but Turk wasn't looking at her and she hesitated, and that was a difference. Oh, chair call for the foul. And we got Gagneau back in. Trombley at the line. What we got going on here? He's going to talk to his team while the first foul shot is taken. This is the first. So Seton's going to give up their offensive rebound. If she misses it, it's going to be a Chazy rebound. But he knew she'd make it. 37-26, an 11-point ball game. 5:53 left in the contest. Knights making it interesting here in the fourth. Off white. Trombley to inbound. Conte will bring it up. For three, Conte. It's in an 8-point ball game, 37-29. Jay-Z is hearing footsteps. The Knights have the mo at the time, at the present time. Playing with lots of confidence out there. As we said, these are a couple of schools that could meet on the road to the Class D finals. Three when the ball is picked up. Off the rim. Rebounded Gagneau. Powell. Back to Langlois. Gagneau cross court to Dunbar. Gagneau is going to come in. Lapierre is going to come back in. I think the case there was Dunbar looking for her shot before she had the ball. It happens often in high school sports. And that'll be a foul on Howell. .16 to go. Off the rim, up here with the rebound. Dunbar back on her feet after falling down. Knights take it away. Wow. Conte on her feet, ready to shoot. She'll shoot two. And we got Dunbar in. She's replacing Gagneau. .42 to go, 8-point ball game. This is the first. Hits them both. Jump ball. Up here in Trombley. Chazy's turn. Knights will apply full court pressure. Turret gets it to Dunbar. Underneath for Lapeer. Yes. Knights going for broke, trying to steal the ball. Back to a 10-point deficit for the Knights and a 10-point lead for the Eagles. Depending on which angle you're looking at. For three. No. Rebounded by Turret. 3 minutes to go. Stolen. A push call. Seton Catholic timeout. 10-point ball game. 2:46 to go. Got the block, I believe, by Lapeer. Dunbar to Langlois. Howell gets it to Turret. Turret at the rebound. Stolen back by Langlois. Andre Langlois. Important steal. From the shoot two. Turk back on her feet. She was down after saving that ball. She hit the floor. 2:12 at the clock. Both teams will look at their foul shots and realize that the difference could have been different either way, depending on who made the foul shots. That one falls off the rim. Out shot is lookout. Oh. That was Bone hitting the floor. Emma Langlois. Where is she? Where's Emma Langlois? Here she is. She's favoring that shoulder. She landed hard on the floor. Could hear her land up here. 2:04, 9-point ball game, a 10-point ball game, 39-29. Knights keep it. Dante hits, 32-29, a 3-pointer, makes it a 7-point deficit with a minute 36 to go. Shot clock is at 19. Turret fakes, gives it up on time. Daniel back in for Dunbar. Timeout, we're set to go. Dunbar shooting her second shot. short and scramble for the ball. Play the whistle. Play the whistle. Blue turn. And the whistle blows. The play is over. Stop fighting for the ball. And the Eagles come up with it. 105. Gagneau. Gives it to Howell. And Trombley. Couldn't quite save it. Good effort. 55.6, 40-32. Chazy is going to hang on. And a good solid comeback here for the Knights. They'll remember this if they meet again in the playoffs. The pair from Howell. Back to a 10-point Chazy lead. For three, nope. And rebound comes out to Gagneau. 25 on the shot clock. About a second and a half more on the game clock than the shot clock. Intended for Turek. Conte read it, steals it. 7.9 to go, Chazy ball. It looks like the final will be 42-32. Chazy Eagles will hang on and defeat the feisty Seton Catholic Lady Knights, and that's the way it was. The NGAC Varsity Girls Basketball Senior Night at Chazy Central Rural School in beautiful downtown Chazy. Thanks for watching and supporting viewer-supported local television hometown cable. Win, lose, or draw, TV worthy of your support. Thank you for watching.